Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Windows Server 2019 in a Mac machine. I will log in. To install a Windows machine in Mac, I need to use a virtualization software, and VirtualBox is a free and pretty good virtualization software that can be used in Mac. So first I will download VirtualBox and then I will create a virtual machine, and inside that virtual machine I will install Windows Server 2019. So go to browser. Then I will Google download VirtualBox. And from the site virtualbox.org, I click on the download link. Then I will select OS X host. Allow. The download is complete, so I will open the downloaded file. And then install VirtualBox. I need to allow in the security preferences. And then click on the lock button. Type the password. And then select App Store and identified developers. And then click on Allow. It needs to restart. I'll restart. After restart, I log in again. I close the security and privacy window. Next, I will go to the launchpad, and VirtualBox is here. So I open VirtualBox. Next, I will create a virtual machine, and also I will need a Windows Server 2019 installer ISO image. I will download the ISO image first, so I go to browser once again and then search download Windows Server 2019. And from the Microsoft site, I select Microsoft Evolution Center. And then download the ISO image. Next, I have to fill up this form. and then click on download now. So select the ISO download, 64-bit edition, and allow. While the file is being downloaded, I will go to VirtualBox. From the VirtualBox home screen, I will click the new icon. And then I will give a name to this virtual machine, Windows Server 2019, 1, 2, 3, 4. From type, I will select Microsoft Windows because I'm gonna install a Windows Server. From version, I will select Windows 2019, 64-bit, and then click on continue. I will keep the memory as 2 GB and then continue. I will create a new virtual hard disk and then create. Different virtualization platform creates different format of virtual hard disk. VirtualBox uses VDI and VMware Workstation uses VHD. I will keep VDI and select continue. Dynamically allocated and continue. This is going to be the name of the virtual hard disk, and for the size I will use minimum 50 GB. We'll need 32 GB for just installing Windows Server 2019, but if you install other component then you will need a little more space, and also for data you might need a little more space. So I'll keep 50 GB and create. So the basic virtual machine has been created. Now I need to mount the ISO file to start the installation. The ISO file is still being downloaded, so I will wait for this download to finish. Downloading the ISO image of Windows Server 2019 is complete. So I go to VirtualBox, select the virtual machine that I created, and then go to settings. And then I go to storage tab and select the CD drive and then browse and select choose a disk file. Then I go to the downloads folder and select the ISO image for Windows Server 2019 that I downloaded before. And then click on open and then OK. Now I can start this machine and it will start the installation. I need to allow in system preferences. So click on the unlock icon and then put the password. And select VirtualBox. I will do it later. And then I will close this window. Next, accessibility permission. If I do need accessibility, then I will allow that. For now, I'm clicking deny on my machine. Now in the background, Windows Server installation has started and it is waiting for user input. The language selection and time and the keyboard, all I will keep default and go next. Then click on install now. I will close this 2 messages as well. And from here, there are 4 available options. 2 of them are desktop and 2 of them are server core. If I choose the standard edition, which doesn't have desktop experience, then after installation, I will end up with a command prompt only. No graphical user interface, no icons. but the desktop experience loads the graphics. So I will select either standard evolution desktop experience or data center evolution desktop experience. Then I will go next. I accept the license terms and then next. Here I will select custom and then next. It's going to take a couple of minutes to finish this installation, so I will wait. The machine is restarting. Now I will create an administrator password to log in into Windows Server. You need to use uppercase letter, lowercase letter, digits, and a special character in the password. Then I click on Finish. The installation is complete. Now to log in into Windows Server, I need to send Control Alt Delete key, and in VirtualBox I can send that key by going to the input menu of VirtualBox and then keyboard and select Insert Control Alt Del. Then I log in with the password that I created before. I'll click on Yes for network discovery. And the server manager loads automatically. And I will close the Windows Admin Center message. Finally, I'm gonna install guest editions in VirtualBox so that the display of the guest machine or Windows screen can be full screen. I can get a better mouse integration and can share folders, can copy paste between guest machine and the host machine and so on. First, I will unmount the Windows Server Installer ISO image from the Mac CD drive. So I select VirtualBox on the desktop and then right click and then select eject. Next, I will go to VirtualBox's devices menu and then insert guest edition's CD image. Then I will open File Explorer in Windows Server and then expand this PC and then go to CD drive and then run VBox Windows Editions. Go through this wizard. The guest editions in VirtualBox is equivalent to VMware tools in VMware Workstation. I need to restart. To log in, I'll go to Input menu of VirtualBox, Keyboard, and then Insert Ctrl+Alt+Del. And log in. Close this message and then Server Manager is loaded. Next, I will maximize this Windows Server window. And now I can get a full screen of Windows Server 2019 in VirtualBox. If you do not install guest editions in VirtualBox, then you will not get a full screen of your virtual machine. And that is the end of this video. I hope you found this video was helpful. If you'd like to receive notifications on future videos, please make sure you're subscribed to my channel and set up notifications by tapping on the bell. Thank you for watching.